Moving on, Amar Singh, Head Advisory, Angel Broking, joins us on the show as well. Good morning, Amar, and welcome to the show. What are the top picks that we could be watching out for in today's day of trade?
Yeah, a very good morning to you. The top picks, the first one is Apollo Hospitals. What we are witnessing in Apollo Hospitals is that this particular stock, if we look at Apollo Hospitals, it has been consolidating, and after a significant correction from almost, if you look at 1100 levels, it has bounced back and continues to consolidate around 950, 960 odd levels. So this is one stock which is around crucial support levels, and also if you look at the different time frames, be it the long term charts or the intermediate term trend, they are in oversold territory, so clearly reflecting the fact that there is very strong support and there could also be some buying coming in. So this is one stock one can look at. So any dip towards 945, 950, that can be used to initiate a long position in Apollo Hospitals with a stop loss of 907 and a target of 1035 on the upside. And the second stock to look at is from the pharma space, and that is Sun Pharma. What we are witnessing in Sun Pharma, and you'd say across the pharma space, that the pharma stocks really have been holding ground, and also they've been moving up. So and also if you look at it, the charts technically from a intermediate as well as a short term trend, that remains positive. Long term trend, I would say that that's still in a neutral zone after the hammering which was witnessed in most of the pharma stocks. So I would say that Sun Pharma is a buy. So any dip towards 570 can be used to initiate a long position with a stop loss of 553 and a target of 604 in the short term.
Well, those are the calls coming here. If you're bullish on Sun Pharma, Amar, what's your view on a couple of other stocks? Pyramid Enterprise yesterday, sharp movements on both sides seen in the stock, but still ended with good sort of volumes on the positive side here. Lupin, another stock again where some good positive momentum was being seen, and Granules again, good sort of bullish open interest addition being seen. All three stocks again were actually on the bullish side here. So, Amar, are they looking good on the charts, and can there be some sort of long positions which should be initiated?
First, talking about Piramal Enterprises, what we are witnessing in Piramal Enterprises is that the stock did correct and then it found support. If you look at the level, somewhere around 2300 odd levels, and from there it has bounced back significantly. But yesterday's closing, if you look at the stock, that is a more of a shooting star formation on the daily chart. So that clearly reflects that the stock is now seems to be capped on the upside. However, the overall trend still remaining positive. So any dip can be used as a buying opportunity. Ideally, I would say that somewhere around 2750, 2770, that could be a good level to enter this stock with a stop loss below 2700 and a target of 2950 on the upside. So this is one stock. The other one you talked about is Lupin. So if I look at Lupin, what we are witnessing in Lupin is that overall in terms of the pharma space, if I look at Lupin, this stock again has bounced back, but it has been more of a consolidation in Lupin, because on the downside, if I look at Lupin, somewhere around 780, that's now should act as a crucial support. On the upside, I would say anywhere between 900 and 920, that should act as an immediate resistance. If I look at it technically, the intermediate term trend and the short term trend remains positive, but the long term trend is also now showing signs of some positive up move. But for that to get confirmed, the stock needs to consistently trade above 900 odd levels. So that's the second stock, and the third stock which you mentioned was?
Right. So Amar, those were Granules, Lupin and Pyramal Enterprise.
Yeah, so now coming to the third stock, Granules. If I look at Granules India, what we are seeing here is that this stock, if I look at technically, the stock has bounced back significantly from almost 70 odd levels to currently around 105. And the reason primarily was that the stock took strong support around 70 odd levels, because that was a crucial support. If I look at it technically from a medium term perspective, somewhere the stock is likely to run into stiff resistance around 110, 112. So that would be a level, ideally those who are long, they should look at booking profits, because the stock would find it extremely difficult to sustain above that level, and we could also witness some selling pressure. So I would say that the upside seems to be capped till the time it doesn't take out 110, 115 zone consistently and stays above that and closes above that. So I would say that one should look at booking profits in this particular counter.
Right. So that, Amar, coming to you, what are charts indicating with regards to where ONGC is concerned for today's day of trade?
Yeah, looking at ONGC, what I would say is that ONGC seems to be meeting with resistance around somewhere around 170, 175 zone. It did manage to bounce back from almost 150 odd levels. And looking at the charts, I would say that there is very strong resistance on the upside on the long-term charts as well. So till the time the stock really doesn't take out 175, 180, that's that resistance level, I would say the stock is likely to trade sideways. Yes, what definitely does appear to be is that a bottom has been formed, so it's likely to consolidate, I would say, 150 on the downside and 180 on the upside till the time we don't see a breach above 180.
But moving on, in terms of other stock specific action as well, consumption as a space is also looking pretty good lately. Amar, coming to you, any top picks from the consumption space?
Yeah, I would say that one can look at Hindustan Unilever, because if you look at this particular counter, what we witnessed was the stock somewhat corrected. If you look at the levels from almost 1780 levels, it corrected all the way to 1640, 1650 levels. So the stock, and from there it has bounced back. It was a significant bounce back from those levels. So clearly reflecting that this stock still seems to have its momentum and going. And also if you look at the stock on different time frames, be it the weekly or the monthlies, it clearly shows that the bullish trend remains positive and the dip was a buying opportunity. So I would say that any dip in the stock can be used as a buying opportunity. Ideally, I would say a good level would be somewhere around 1720 odd levels with a stop loss at 1680 and a target of 1795 on the upside.
Right. Amar, what's the view on PVR? The stock is up almost 5 to 6% up. There has been a sort of agreements with the online portals, again, renewed agreements at a higher sort of attractive valuation in terms of revenue accretion here. The stock is up 6% here. Amar, any trade on PVR and any other stock which has spotted?
I would say that as far as PVR is concerned, if you look at this, the stock cracked from almost 1450 levels after the Maharashtra government noted that in terms of the edibles which would be priced lower. So after that, the stock is finding support. So somewhere around 1050 odd levels, the stock did find some support and has bounced back. But what I see is that this is more of a just a pullback. Whether it's going to last is something I would say very difficult to say right now. But on the upside, I would say that anywhere around 1200 odd levels, it's going to meet with selling pressure. And also those who bought at lower levels, they would look at booking profits. So the stock is likely to consolidate. But yes, on the downside, 1050, 1060 should act as an immediate support. One stock one can look at is ITC. What we are seeing in ITC is that ITC has been holding firm close to 298-99 levels. And technically, the stock is strong on the charts. So I would say any pullback towards 295-96, that can be used to initiate a long position with a stop loss below 292 and a target of 307 on the upside.
Amar, coming to you, what's the view on Reliance Industries? Is this stock where you feel perhaps a sort of a renewed momentum from yesterday can be seen towards 1200, or yesterday the sort of pullback has already started and we actually can see some cooling off in the second half?
Yeah, I would say as far as Reliance is concerned, there is overall the trend definitely remains positive across different time frames, and it continues to be strong at the same time. Having said that, I would say that the high that was made the day before yesterday of 1203 levels, so that now should act as an immediate level of resistance, because if you look at it from a technical pattern, that is more of a, I would say, a doji formation. So somewhat that is a top which seems to be there, but I would still suggest that any pullback should be used as a buying opportunity, because the trend still remains strong and firm. So I would say that the levels to watch out somewhere on the downside, 1160, 1165, that can be a good level to enter with a stop loss below 1140 and a target of 1200 on the upside.
Amar, just wondering if there is a short-term trade on an all-cargo logistics, or is just a pullback rally, you should stay away from this?
I would say that the stock has definitely,
Ali, you should stay away from this.
I would say that the stock has definitely formed the bottom, and if you look at the stock from almost 200 levels, the stock corrected 50%, and then it has bounced back. So I would say that on the upside, 135, technically 135, 140, that's a very strong resistance zone. So the stock is unlikely to trade above that level. So I wouldn't recommend fresh long at these levels. Yes, any pullback towards 123, 122 can be used as a buying opportunity with a stop loss below 120 and a target of 134 on the upside.
All right, that is on an all cargo right now. Keep that on your radar.
Amar, your last word on any of the stock which is spotted, and also TCS, what is the word coming around that?
Yeah, I would say that I would stick to Sun Pharma, because Sun Pharma is one stock which is really bounced back. We had talked about in the morning as well. So currently it's around 580, 586 level. So that still has got momentum on the upside. So one can take a position in that and target of 604 on the upside. Talking about TCS, what we are witnessing in TCS is that TCS definitely continues to be extremely strong on the intermediate as well as the long-term charts. Short-term, we've been witnessing some consolidation, because if you look at this particular stock, it was unable to trade above to maintain above 2000 odd levels. But on the downside, again, it has got very strong support coming around 1930, 1920 odd levels. So there is a high possibility that once it takes out its high of 1980, 85 on the upside, we could see TCS again pulling on the upside. So this is one stock one can definitely look at initiating long positions.
All right. So TCS, definitely keep that on your radar as well. Amar, Dhyaneshwar, Parthiv, as well as Ashish, appreciate your time this morning. Thank you for joining in. Markets on form footing, rebound coming in after a 100-point shed on the Nifty yesterday. You've